Good morning and welcome. A special welcome to any visitors that we have with us today and also our radio listeners. Today we celebrate the 20th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our entrance hymn is number 671 in the hymnal, Glory and Praise to Our God, number 671.
In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Thank you. Welcome. Praying ourselves for this mass, let's begin by calling to mind our sins and asking God's forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you are the Son of Man and Son of God. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you are the bread that came down from heaven. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you give us life through your body and blood. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, make us life everlasting.
Amen.
Join together in Gloria. Glory,
glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God,
let us pray. O God, prepare for those who love you good things with no eye can see. Fill our hearts with praise, with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things, and above all things, maintain your work promises, surpasses even human desire. The Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. Wisdom has built her house. She has set up her seven columns. She has dressed her meat, mixed her wine. Yes, she has spread her table. She has sent out her maidens. She calls from the heights out of over the city. Let whoever is simple turn in here. To the one who lacks understanding, she says, come eat of my food and drink of the wine I have mixed. Forsake foolishness that you may live. Advance in the way of understanding. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, watch carefully how you live, not as foolish persons, but as wise, making the most of the opportunity, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not continue in ignorance, but try to understand what is the will of the Lord. And do not get drunk on wine, in which lies debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit, addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and playing to the Lord in your hearts, giving thanks always and for everything, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowds, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When I was at the Newman Center Club in Missouri, each year we take college students different locations during spring break to work on some project. It might be caring for the homeless, it might be teaching kids, but somewhere there, way or another, we're involved with students and communities. One year I went to Washington, D.C. I had 20 kids or so. We stayed at a formerly a college dorm. Small little place. Part of it was used for dorm. Part of it was also used for other things. One of the places, offices, buildings, was used for AA meetings. And they invited us to come and to come to one of their meetings. That's one evening, we all went to the AA meeting. Probably were about 20 of us and maybe 30 of them. But if people come to AA meetings, don't come to share their talents, don't come to share what's good about them, they come to share about how they're struggling. And to know that they need to come to the AA meetings, because if they don't, they will die. In many ways, AA is what keeps them alive, keeps them going. Going through the ritual helps them to make it through the next day. And just as they needed to come to those meetings, what's here about today's gospel, we need to come to Eucharist.
This is where we are nourished. The Lord gives us manna from heaven, gives us his body and blood, gives himself to us. It simply is not a reminder, it really is Jesus' presence being there for us. Oftentimes, or a number of times throughout my priesthood, I have gone to the monk's place, Aunt Abel, or Gethsemane, where the monks really have a routine to go through. They know to get up in the middle of the night, say prayers. 6 o'clock, they have mass, morning prayers. They're probably in bed by 8:30, 9 o'clock. But they go through that ritual, routine. It keeps them alive, keeps them going on, helps them stay dedicated to the Lord. How much that ritual is needed. When I was growing up, there's 4 kids and my mom and dad. We probably didn't realize at the time we had ritual. I wanted to have a meal together. Every night about 5:30, we had supper. Didn't matter what we were doing, where we were at, we knew at 5:30 we needed to be home. That was our ritual. I remember thinking about my uncle and their family, they would come together, might be different times, and they would sit around the TV. Ours was always around the dinner table. Maybe sharing about our day, what's happening, but as a ritual to help make for us for a good family. We come here for Mass because we need it. We know that we need to have the Lord be part of our lives. He's the substance. We say that this is the source and summit of our faith. This is what's important. We need to be here. There's a phrase I learned in one of my retreats, and it simply went, trust, surrender, believe, receive. Trust, surrender, believe, receive. Receive the Lord Jesus. That's what's important. Each time we come from Mass, we come to receive the Lord into our hearts and lives. He's the one that makes a difference for us. We know that we need the body and blood of our Lord to help keep us going. St. Paul says, Christian's life, we walk by faith and not by sight. We walk by faith and not by sight. So what we see, bread and wine. But our faith tells us the body and blood of our Lord that nourishes us in life's journey. And certainly there are times throughout our church history that there's been miracles. It was back in 1263, a young priest from Prague was en route to Rome, trying to deepen his faith, trying to grasp that this really was Jesus' presence. And on the way there, he stopped at the place to celebrate Mass. It was 90 miles or so from Rome. He celebrated Mass there. The wine was spilled. It really was the blood of Christ. Spilled on the corporal. The corporal, even today, is in there in a monstrous type of thing. It's on display. In fact, I went there with some college students and other adults on a little vacation there. You got to see it. It was still there. Still very much awareness that this was the Lord's presence. You know, throughout the summer, we have young people retreats called Steubenville, probably in 20 locations. One of the things they all say about is the most important part of that retreat weekend, 2 days, is time for adoration. Time to speak to the Lord face to face, heart to heart. Know he's there for them. Each time we come here to Mass, opportunity to speak to our Lord. Receive the Lord. Lord, make a difference for us. So let's make sure that we take time. Time to the Lord, to allow the Lord to speak to our hearts and lives. That's why it's so important to think after communion, we just receive the Lord, we take that time to speak to the Lord, allow him to speak to us. He wants to speak to us of his love, his forgiveness, and care for us. Let's be thankful for the great sacrament we have in Eucharist, the Lord's God, body and blood, pouring out itself for us.
And let us stand. Join together in the Nicene Creed. I believe one God,
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made, for our sin and for our salvation.
And so this time we come to bring our prayers and needs to God our Father.
Heavenly Father, we pray for the gift of wisdom, that partaking of wisdom's table of word and sacrament, we may grasp the meaning and purpose of life God gives us. Let us pray to the Lord. That we may grow in trust of Christ's gentle yet powerful touch that we encounter each time we come together and celebrate this holy gift of the Mass. Let us pray to the Lord. For unity among Christians, that all who bear the name Christian will work to heal the wounds suffered by the living body of Christ on earth. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who hunger for freedom, for just treatment and meaning in their lives, that they may find their longings fulfilled by consuming the gospel message and living it in their lives, let us pray to the Lord. For all who live in conditions of poverty, that we with our abundance may assist those without clean water, food, shelter, or clothing, let us pray to the Lord. For all who serve our nation, those who work as relief workers and members of our military, that God may keep them safe in their duties and allow their service to be fruitful, let us pray to the Lord. For our students and teachers at Valley Catholic and St. Genevieve schools, that they be willing to take advantage of the opportunity to grow and learn that is placed before them in this new school year. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who struggle with poor health in mind, body, or spirit, that the Lord of life restore them to full health. Let us pray to the Lord. And for our beloved dead, may the God of the resurrection raise them up to new life. Let us pray to the Lord. And now, gracious and merciful God, we bring you those prayers and intentions that we hold in our hearts. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we're so thankful for this gift of communion, the gift of Eucharist, thankfulness, thankful for your great love. We ask you to answer these our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As our guests are prepared, let us sing number 172 in the hymnal, Lord, You Have the Words, number 172.
And let us stand. Brothers and sisters, let us pray that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the good of his holy church.
Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought a glorious exchange, that we're offering what you have given, we merit to receive your very self, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, mighty eternal God, for we know it belongs to your boundless glory. You came to aid of mortal beings with your divinity, even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that it cause our downfall by becoming the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through the host of angels, adore your majesty and rejoice your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs, and one chorus accept the praise as we acclaim. The third Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all created right to give you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you light all things and make them holy. Never cease to gather people to yourself. So rising the sun to a setting, a pure sacrifice we offer to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit which you make holy, the gifts we brought to you for consecration, they may become the body and blood of our Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, giving thanks for the blessing, broke the bread and gave the disciples, saying, take this, all of you need of it, for this is my body, which is given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving thanks at the blessing, gave the chalice to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink of it, for the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and from cups poured out for you and for many forgiveness of sins, do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, a separate memorial of the saved passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and look forward to his second coming, we offer you thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the invitation of your church, and recognize sacrifice the victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make us an eternal offering to you, so we may attain inheritance with your elect, as blessed most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, St. Genevieve, with all the saints, whose intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, O Lord, we pray, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm with in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our bishop and all the clergy, and the entire people you gain for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, who have summoned before you, passion and worship of Father. Gather yourself all your children, scattered throughout the world. To our brothers and sisters, to all who are pleased to you, and the passing from this life, give kind of mission to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow all the world, all that is good. Through him and with him in him, O God Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And so at the Savior's command, if one of the divine teaching, we dare to pray together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, I pray, from every evil. Grace and grant peace in our days. Give us help and your mercy. We may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. As we bless the hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory, and the yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace leave my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grace and grant her peace in unity and force with your will. Lives reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Thank you. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed those called to supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you enter under my roof,
Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is number 524 in the hymnal, Behold the Lamb, number 524. Thank you.
And let us pray. May partakers of Christ through these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed this image on earth, we merit also be co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Our Parish School of Religion program is in need of an eighth grade teacher. If you or someone you know is interested, please call the Parish Center. Our recessional hymn is number 543 in the hymnal, Take the Word of God with You, number 543.
Again, I just want to reemphasize that we do need an eighth grade teacher for PSR. So if you're interested, if you have questions about it, please make sure you contact one of us and we will try to answer questions, but certainly want people to pray about it and think if you're being called. The Lord with you.
And with your spirit.
May God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has ended. Let us go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks.